Hello everyone. Today we will be carrying out a small discussion on the control of cutting temperature by application of cutting fluid. Now, if we employ a cutting fluid during machining, then it reduces the cutting temperature directly by taking away the heat from the cutting zone and also indirectly by reducing the generation of heat by reducing the cutting forces. So both these functions played by the cutting fluid in case of machining are extremely welcome functions. Just because reduction of cutting temperature during machining is of prime necessity. Now during machining, heat is generated as a result of the work done. Now heat is carried away from the tool and the workpieces, the workpiece, by means of cutting fluid, which at the same time reduces the friction between the tool and the chip and also between the tool and the workpiece, and thereby facilitates the chip formation. Now cutting fluid is usually in form of liquids and gases. Cutting fluid is one of the most important aid to improve production efficiency. Now, what are the major functions played by a cutting fluid? What are the major role played by a cutting fluid in case of machining? The first important function which has been played by a cutting fluid is that it cools the cutting tool and the workpiece. The heat produced is carried away by the cutting fluid by supplying adequate quantity, if adequate quantity of cutting fluid is been supplied. Now, the second function which has been carried away by a cutting fluid is that it lubricates the cutting tool and thereby reduces the coefficient of friction between the chip and the tool. This in turn increases the life of the tool. The cutting tool. The use of cutting fluid results in better surface finish. Now, as the friction is getting reduced by application of cutting fluid, the tool life increases and the power consumption during machining is definitely getting reduced. So, this is another advantage of applying a cutting fluid during machining. Then, application of cutting fluid during machining also causes the chip to break up into small pieces. Then it washes away the chip from the cutting tool, which in turn enhances the performance of the concerned cutting tool. And the cutting fluid also prevents corrosion of the workpiece and the machine tool on which machining has been done. So all these are the advantageous effects of employing a cutting fluid during machining. These are the advantages offered by a cutting fluid if it has been used during machining. Now, in order to offer all the advantages which I have mentioned just now, what are the essential properties the cutting fluid must possess? Number one, it should have a high specific heat. It should have high heat conductivity and high film coefficient. It should possess good lubricating properties to reduce frictional forces and to decrease power consumption. It should be odorless. It should be non-corrosive to both to the workpiece material as well as to the machine tool material on which machining is being carried out, as well as to the material of the cutting tool. It should be non-toxic to the operators. It should have low viscosity to permit free flow of the liquid. It should be stable in use and in storage. It should permit clear view of the workpiece, which is especially desirable in precision work. Otherwise, it may create a negative impact in case of proper dimensional accuracy of the finished workpiece. It should be safe, particularly with respect to fire and accident has arisen. So all these are some essential properties which a cutting fluid must possess in order to offer the advantages which we have discussed a little bit earlier. Now, generally, cutting fluids are employed in liquid form, but occasionally, the cutting fluids are also employed in gaseous form. Often, solid lubricants are also employed in machining and in grinding. The cutting fluids which are commonly used are basically air blast or compressed air, water, soluble oil, cutting oil, chemical fluids, solid or semi-solid lubricant, for example, paste, wax, graphite, and so on. And finally, cryogenic cutting fluid. Cryogenic cutting fluid means these are extremely cold cutting fluids at cryogenic temperature, often in form of gases like liquid nitrogen. Are used in, and this type of cutting fluids are used in some special cases for effective cooling without creating much environmental pollution and health hazards. So these are the different types of cutting fluids. As far as air blast or compressed air is concerned, it has been used for machining of some materials like grey cast iron. Just because it becomes inconvenient or difficult if any cutting fluid is employed in liquid form. Water. Water is basically used for its good wetting and spreading properties and very high specific heat. Water is considered as the best coolant and hence employed where cooling is most urgent. Then, as I told you, soluble oil, then cutting oils, chemical fluids, and the remaining fluids which I have already explained so far. So this much for today. Thank you. Thank you so much for your patient hearing. Hello everyone. Today we'll be carrying